What's up, folks?
All right.
Welcome to the graveyard shift in the wee hours of the night. This is Michael. Back at it once again, folks. Hope everybody's week is going good. I hope you're staying dry. This week has been kind of a washout. I'm supposed to get better for the weekend, though. All right, here we go. All right, let's get right to it, folks. The answer to the previous trivia question was none other than the toy company called Legos. Folks, I made this easy. Legos, we all know what Legos are. So a man named Ole Kirk Christensen began making wooden toys. This is where it all started, in his workshop in 1932. It goes back to the 1930s. 2 years later, he would name his company Lego after the Danish phrase Legot. I'm sure I'm pronouncing that wrong. I'm sure I'm butchering that to no end, and as I usually do in my trivia questions. But if I am, please forgive me. That's my disclaimer. That, of course, translates for Danish into play well. That's the origins of Legos. All right. So in 1949, Lego produced its first plastic brick, which would eventually lead to the famous signature brick design with interlocking studs that we all know to this day. On the top, and of course, tubes on the bottom. They're all interlocking building blocks, basically, is what it is. Pretty cool stuff. It was patented, which is very significant, in 1958 by Christensen's son, Gottfried Kirk, who would go on to replace his father as the head of the Lego company. Now, the iconic and famous plastic building block toys, as we all know, would rise to massive popularity in the mid-20th century, catching on very quickly, first and foremost throughout Europe. It is not an American toy. It's not where its origins are. Of course, they hit the United States as early as 1962, and it was all over but for shouting after that. Of course, everybody, it was a craze after that. Everybody had to have Legos. And as early as 1968, this is interesting, the first Legoland theme park opened in Billund, which is in Denmark. And that is still there to this day. It serves as the location of the head office of the Lego Group. In 1969, they added larger size bricks for younger children, which you may have seen in stores as well. And in the 1970s, they introduced those creepy, I call them creepy little minifigures, which are the smiling yellow humanoids that become regularly included in the company's themed play sets and kits. And they have like interchangeable helmets and stuff like that. I think they're creepy myself. Anyways, the cool geek factoids about Lego. And this was really an interesting company to research. And there are some cool geek factoids. The basic Lego brick, check this out, has remained the same since it was patented. And this simple child-friendly design has been credited with the toy's longevity. So the design has not changed in the over 80-something odd years that it's been around. Lego has remained in the Christensen family for generations, and it still is in that family's name to this day. I thought that was pretty cool. Lego toys were among the inaugural inductees to the U.S. National Toy Hall of Fame in 1998. Did not know such a thing existed. There are Legos in the Smithsonian, I also found in my research. And of course, it culminated into what we have in today's day and age. There was a Lego movie in 2014, which consisted of a computer animated feature film that revolved around the exploits of those creepy little minifigures. It had a cool lineup too in it. I think I included a picture of it in my initial trivia question. It was a pretty good cast. It was a pretty popular cast. Batman, who was one of the characters from that film, eventually had a standalone spinoff called the Lego Batman movie, and that was in 3 years later, in 2017. I think there hasn't been anything recent as far as movies and Legos go since then. The Lego brand has always spun off into multiple electronic games. That's kind of the new age of Legos, if you will. I did not know that. I'm interested in learning more about that and doing more research and hearing from people who have who are into electronic games as far as Legos go. However, if you're anything like me, nothing beats the good old-fashioned regular-sized Lego design, complete with whatever kind of kit and challenge you want to tackle and put together that you can buy anywhere. Legos are everywhere. And like I said, nothing beats those traditional kits that come. You open it up. It's kind of a rite of passage of childhood, folks. Every child wants Legos. Every child wants to have some ingenuity and creativity and building stuff, and Legos certainly provides that for all generations. One of my favorite Lego kits was like the Star Wars, anything spaceship, anything NASA related. And what I would do was build whatever kit it was with the instructions, right? But then I would throw the instructions out and just build my own kind of whatever, building, spaceship. That's the whole kind of creativity aspect of childhood and Legos. That's what it kind of brings out. It's certainly a part of everyone's childhood history, and it makes for a really cool research and trivia question. Kids still demand Legos as the toy of choice to this day. I was recently at a five-year-old's birthday party, and the first thing out of his mouth was that he wanted more Legos. We wanted Legos. And this was 2023. So what are some of your favorite kits that you've put together for Legos growing up? That's what I'd like to know. Reach out to me and let me know by all means your Lego experience. All right, folks, let's wrap up the week. Happy Friday, by the way. Get your Friday dance going on. Let's wrap up this week and get ready for a dry weekend. And hopefully the rain will move out with a brand new trivia question for February 3rd. It's already February. Oh, my gosh. January is over with, folks. We're rolling into 2023. Here we go for February 3rd on this day in 1986. President Ronald Reagan signs an executive order authorizing the formation of a commission to investigate this national tragedy that consisted of a 12-member panel, including the likes of Neil Armstrong, Sally Ride, and Chuck Yeager. Good luck, folks. Have a good day. Happy Friday, folks. Peace out.